Hello everyone, welcome to the first video of our platformer game series. In this video, we will create a project from scratch, and we are gonna do movement system using the input system. Let's get started. Open Unity Hub, and click on New Project. Select 2D template. I named the project 2D Platformer. We need to determine the location where the project will be created. I will create a new folder named Make a Game. And I select it for the project location. Click on Create Project button. That it may take some time to create the project. Our project has been created. I will change the layout. You can customize workspace. As you can see, when the project is first created, there is only the camera object. I drag and drop the images that we will use in the project to the project panel. You can find the images in the description. I will create a folder named Sprite. And drag the images into it. We should work clean in the game making process. Let's create player object. I drag and drop the player image onto the scene panel. Then I will add Box Collider 2D and Rigid Body 2D components. And I will create a simple ground object. Let's give the player movement ability. Select player object and add movement controller script. Open the movement controller script. RB represents rigid body 2D component of the player. I define two variables named speed and speed multiplier to set the speed of the player. I write the code related to the physics system in the fixUpdate method. We can move the player using velocity or add force. We're gonna use velocity. I'm gonna use the new input system to detect inputs. So we're gonna install input system package. We have to restart Unity to complete the installation. Installation is completed. I'm gonna create input actions named player actions. If you are seeing the new input system for the first time, it may seem a little confusing. I think you should definitely use the new input system. I wanna move the player when I press space key. I'll define the movement key, so click on listen and press space key. Player actions is ready. Select player and add player input component. Then drag and drop player actions into the slot. Back the movement controller script. I created method to detect inputs. I'll connect the method to movement event. When I press the spacebar, the speed multiplier will be 1. Back to Unity and test it. Set the speed to 5 and start the game. Nice, the player moves when I press the spacebar, but there is some jitter. Let's fix it. Set the interpolate to interpolate. It's a little better like this. As you can see, the character suddenly accelerates and stops. I created a method named updateSpeedMultiplier to smooth the movement. When we press the movement button, SpeedMultiplier will increase up to 1 smoothly. When we hand off the movement button, speed multiplier will decrease smoothly to 0. I'm gonna call the method infixUpdate. Back to Unity and test it. I wanna remove the input action icon. Start the game. As you can see, it accelerates very slowly, in this way. It reaches maximum speed in 1 second. Let's increase the acceleration. I'm gonna create a variable named acceleration. And I will multiply speed multiplier by acceleration. Set the acceleration and test it. Now we can adjust the acceleration. Now the player accelerates smoothly. As you can see, the player can move in one direction. The next step is turn the direction of the player when it hits a wall. So I'm gonna create a wall. Drag and drop wall image to the scene panel and add box collider to the component. Then set its layer as wall. Duplicate with Ctrl the shortcut. Start the game. Let's increase the speed a little. As you can see, the player stopped when it hit the wall. We can flip the player using scale or rotation. We're gonna use rotation. We need to detect that the player is touching a wall and flip its direction. Back the movement controller script. I'm gonna use the same logic as ground check. I will detect touch with a wall. If it touches a wall, I will flip the player. I will create check area for detect touching with a wall. I will add a temporary collider to determine the size of the checkpoint area. this is a wall checkpoint area. I write the size values that I have determined here. Drag and drop wall checkpoint object into the slot. Don't forget to remove the temporary box collider. Start the game. As you can see, the player flips when hits the wall, but doesn't continue move. Let's move the player in the direction it's turning by using its local transform. I will create new method named updateRelativeTransform. And I will call it in the flip method and start method. Back to Unity and test it. Nice, player movement system is ready. In the next video of the series, we're gonna learn the level design by using tilemap. Please don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching, see you in the next video.